Whoa! That's the animation. We go live. Whoa! Welcome everyone to another developer playtest. Oh, feels like we haven't done this in weeks because we've been
because we haven't done this for weeks
because we literally haven't done it for weeks. Totally. So this is what we do on Tuesdays at 1:30 p.m. PST. Mm-hmm. We do the developer playtest, which is a completely internal playtest. The 10 people you'll see playing in this game are developers on the game. That, you know, we've got artists, we've got audio directors, so we've got Mr. Caleb Necobus Epps here with
us.
Hi,
everybody.
You may see him in chat all the time, pretty much answering questions and really taking a lot of the pressure off of myself and Andy, which we very much appreciate.
I do what I can.
He is going to be showing us how to play some Zalgus today.
How to play, ha ha ha.
How to play, or we're gonna he's going to show us, let me correct that, he's going to show us how he plays his Zalgus.
Right.
Which may or may not be objectively the correct way to play Zalgus, but it is a way.
Yeah.
And that is a
but fact. You know what, like, doing this is actually, I think, really good for people who are new to the game, because it's like, here I am. I'm
newish to the game.
Newish, not newish. I mean, I've been working on this game for a while, but I'm not like god tier.
But I would say maybe your MOBA experience is limited. Correct.
Yeah,
did you play a lot of League and Dota and stuff like that? Like, what,
yeah,
did you
yeah.
have a MOBA background? Okay.
Yeah, totally. I got into it. I mean, I got into it late, so I got into it. I was making music games at Harmonix, and my buddy John Venren, who's a producer over there, he was like, "Hey, come play this game, League of Legends," and so I got started on that. And
I feel like that's how
Dota,
that's how most people get into the League, like MOBA scene.
Somebody
it's
sort
like
of
someone,
sidles up
yeah,
to them and
like,
is like, "Hey,
you want to play League of Legends?" And
yeah.
he's like, "The hell is League of Legends?" And
right.
then all of a sudden you're addicted and you're pouring money in, and you know, that's
totally.
That's MOBA in a nutshell. The experience of playing with friends.
The first time is free. Yeah.
Exactly. Every other time you have to buy skins and champions and shapers and, you know, all
yeah,
that kind of stuff.
Totally.
But yes, so this is a servers are not live. We'll go ahead and, you know, reaffirm that. They should be live this weekend as they usually are.
Mm-hmm.
The times you've come to know and love, probably Thursday through Sunday. But we will, you know, officially make the announcement, of course, tomorrow, like we do on the forums and Twitter
totally.
And Facebook and stuff like that. To introduce myself, I am the Ginger. I am Brad Pluto Ramey, the assistant community manager. We are trying to get into a game right now. We're testing also the matchmaking system within the internal build. So the 10 devs are in solo queue. And, you know, sometimes people are like, oh, when you custom balance the teams, some people say, oh, this is unfair, or this isn't right. So we just let the matchmakatron do the work. And then what's there to complain
like
about?
Like magic.
You know, it's like it working as intended at that point. So we're
Mikello's
here.
Mikello's not in queue. Okay.
Cool. Oh, my gosh, Mikello. What a silly person. So... what we do is play the game. We're going to show you guys gameplay for the next hour or so. Usually the game lasts maybe until 2, 2:30, something like that.
Thereabouts.
And if you guys have any questions, you may ask them in chat. We have the chat pulled up on a second monitor. We do ask that you throw like a Q, like a capital Q with a little colon, ask the question, and we will try to answer it as well as we can. Sometimes, you know, they ask crazy design questions, and I'm like, I can't really answer that because I'm not a Ghastie, or I'm not, you know, a hunter or a dibs or anything like
that. Exactly, but we'll do our best.
If you have any audio questions, boom. Like, Caleb, how did you make the noise for the mushroom camps? Oh, you know, I'm Caleb, and I put a bucket on my head, and I made weird noises. Because that is
the
pretty
stuff
much the
stuff of legend, yeah. I actually did put a bucket on my head and made noises for the...
Next time you're killing the mushroom camp, listen for Caleb's weird bucket head noises.
Yeah.
It's going to be fantastic. You know, he'll also throw down some audio tidbits, like one of my favorite ones that you said was the sound from Mikella's coins are actually like bullets.
Yeah, they're
like being
bullet
like
casings.
Jangled and
yep.
stuff. It's not you didn't because if you're trying to make the sound for a coin, why use actual coins?
Right.
When you can use bullets.
Exactly. So, I'm playing the goose, going loose. When you're doing sound design for a game, it's like you. If you think about it sort of on the face of it, it's like, oh, well, I'm going to make... A coin is going to sound like a coin, but you don't actually want a coin to sound like a coin. You want it to sound like...
You're launching a projectile.
No, it needs to sound like the coin. Like the coin the coin of your dreams, right? The coin that you hear in your head when you think of what a coin sounds like.
A coin flip is, yeah.
Yeah, and then you are... It leads to a whole world of disappointment. I'm disappointed in reality constantly.
You pretty much were like, I need a coin sound. You probably took some coins and tried to record, and you're like,
and I was
this
like,
doesn't
this doesn't sound
like coins.
Right. Yeah. And then you make your own. And that's kind of how sound design works.
There you go. Do weird things. Go sit in your, see like the platonic coin.
So yeah, right, exactly. The platonic coin. Yeah.
The perfect coin.
The perfect coin ever. Yeah.
Do.
I forget what, we were talking about which philosopher it was who talked about, God, we're getting so deep in this, on the stream. Deep thoughts.
Yeah. Philosophy. We're deep thoughts with Caleb.
We were talking, I don't know, was it Heidegger? Heidegger's chair, like the idea of like the chair, the sort of,
Who talked about this? Was I in on this?
No.
Okay. I don't know what Heidegger's chair is.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Right, yeah,
exactly. Schrodinger's cat sit in Heidegger's chair?
Right, exactly.
While ringing Pavlov's bell?
Yeah, is that what it is? And just drooling. Constantly drooling.
Welcome to Waystone Games Deep Cuts. Yep. We talk about anything and everything that you guys want to talk about.
Totally. So we're about to drop into the game, and I'll be playing Zalgus, who's a mage.
Mm-hmm.
Also a ginger, in your honor.
Thank you, I appreciate that. He is a super high burst, long-range mage as well. Not to be confused, Amaranth, a little bit shorter range is what Amaranth has, but still fantastic burst. His kit, if you wanted to make somewhat of an analog to League, a little bit like Lux, you know, that long range burst capability. He can lock people down with his Q, deal good AoE damage with his E, and his ultimate is that super long range laser that has a reset mechanic to it, where if you deal a killing blow, you can keep casting the laser as long as you keep casting, keep dealing killing blows in like a 12-second window.
Exactly. So you can get some crazy resets.
Yeah.
And only basically
only hits Shapers, though.
Yes, only hits Shapers, single target.
And it only hits the first Shaper. So
yeah.
It can be blocked. It can completely whiff. You can't, like, siege and clear creep waves with it forever. And on the counter side of that, you can't just turtle and clear creep waves forever. It only hits Shapers, which I think is a very important distinction kind of between, like, a Lux laser and a Goose laser.
Very true.
Can you make one champion speak exclusively in pirate? Somebody wants you to.
Yar, matey.
Yar. I feel like that would be a great like Moya VO pack where she just speaks in pirate.
Just all pirate all the time.
She is a smuggler.
She is. She is a pirate boat captain.
Let's see. Any other questions you guys might have? By the way, like I said, give us a cue with a colon and. State your question afterwards, and we'll try to answer it to the best of our ability.
Oh, man, I'm taking...
You're walking through them eggs, son.
I don't like the eggs. Trying to trade and not doing so well.
Any questions you guys might have? Is the beta more or less open now since people can get keys off of Liking, Facebook/Logitech? So, I would... It's still very much a closed beta.
Absolutely, and that's a limited time...
Exactly,
limited time offer. Right.
Yeah, it's a finite number of keys. So once those keys are gone, it will go back to kind of the process of us giving away keys on stream, having to register at dawngate.com, all that kind of stuff, which is stuff that hopefully you guys have already done. And the Logitech keys are kind of just a way to, like, get your hands on one immediately. You know?
Exactly.
Because sometimes people are waiting for keys once they've registered and stuff like that. And like Scott pretty much chimed in and said, they are a finite number of keys. So once the Logitech keys are gone, we'll go back to the old ways that you guys have come to know, and I don't know about love, but it's the way you guys have come to know.
Look at Big Friday being such a champ and helping out, taking so much damage.
I know.
That.
What a kind
soul. He is a kind soul.
Here's a good one. A4V Fallen. What's the most difficult sound you had to make for the Dawn game?
Oh, well, the one that I redid the most.
I suppose so. Yeah, one that maybe had the most iteration.
Yeah.
Ooh, there's a foot.
Gave me the most trouble. I'm trying to think. I did go in and completely redo Nisa's auto attack audio.
Uh-huh.
Because basically, so, you know, Gasty joined the team and was sort of messing around with trying to get the feel of last hitting, and he was like, something's not right with the way that last hitting feels from an audio standpoint in our game. And he was sort of testing on Nisa. Oh, gotcha. So basically, sort of, we tried to nail it down, because audio is a really hard, it's a hard thing to kind of, I'll use a coderly word, debug with non-audio people, because oftentimes it's about feel, right? People are like, this doesn't feel right, and people aren't really conversant in audio terminology, and you know, that's sort of my job to take that and kind of translate it.
Someone non-audio, you know, focus would be like, it just doesn't sound good, or like, it doesn't sound thuddy enough.
And yeah,
like,
exactly.
You're like, oh, you mean it doesn't have enough bass? Or right. Like, you know, like, there's more in less
of a pejorative
less of a
way.
Snooty yeah. kind of thing. But yeah, that's pretty much what Caleb does on a daily basis. Like, you don't hear the bass
enough. Mm, yeah.
So. Why don't I just turn up the bass knob for you? Pretty much like that.
How droll.
But yeah, I mean, I feel like I can understand where you're coming from, just because like, or where Gassy was coming from, rather, of like, last hits are a combination of like a feel and a sound.
Yes,
you know,
exactly.
Like, it's like. One of my favorite auto attacks in League of Legends is Caitlyn's auto attack. Caitlyn's auto attack, super responsive,
yep.
feeling, and super satisfying sounding.
Yes, and I am a Caitlyn player. Caitlyn is when I carry. I don't always carry, but when I do,
I play Caitlyn.
I play Caitlyn. And always had from the very beginning of when I started playing MOBAs.
But yeah,
she was sort of the first character.
I could completely see, like, if you take two of the same kind of champions with the same physical auto attack, but two different sounds.
They're going to feel completely
they're
different.
They're going to feel different.
Yeah,
yeah.
I completely agree. So basically what we realized is that we did not have a frame one auto attack sound. For any of our characters, when I first went in and started sound designing, I was like, well, you know, Nissa throws a boomerang, a Baraga,
yeah.
small one, and get out, King of Masks.
Oh, the flip.
Yeah, nice. I'm trying to use my chain.
Oh, get that. That's a kill. Yeah, buddy.
Dunzo.
Oh, if only you were a predator.
I know.
You didn't go YOLO enough.
True.
I don't know how I feel about this.
Oh, should feel good. At least
good job.
Put her on the
back foot.
On
at
the
least.
Defensive, yep.
Now your Big Friday could go in. Well, you guys are almost level 6, so Big Friday could go for the ulti as soon as he hits level 6.
True.
Which I want him to. Will Korn, if you're listening, please.
Please.
Please dive so hard.
Dive flip. You heard about dive kick. We're talking about dive flip.
Dive kick. I never played that game. I heard it was interesting, though.
Yeah, I have some buddies of mine know those guys, and... hang out with those guys. the Dave Langs of the world. Oh, there we go.
Oh, no.
Oh, wasted.
Unnecessary.
But I'll take it, and I'm going to go by. Where should I hang out? What should I do?
You should go back. Oh, is that guy going to let you back? Oh, maybe you should fight now. Oh, no. As soon as you backed.
So what should I pick up here?
I would pick up the aggression.
Yeah.
And the...
do I have enough for...
Oh, you don't have enough for action. Get the time.
Yeah.
And hunger.
Love
and
that.
Power. Perfect.
Spilled and wide. So one different thing about our item shop is that, if people don't know about it, is that it's items evolve.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than having a combinatorial item shop where it's like this thing and this other thing.
Yeah, rather than taking two swords and combining them into a bigger and better sword,
right.
You take one thing and upgrade it along a path.
Exactly.
And they are, you know, branching paths, obviously.
Yeah.
So pretty much what I'm setting Caleb here for with those item suggestions is those are all items.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
I can't really help him.
Ooh.
Not for another second.
King of Mask missed the ulti, though. That was a really good bolt by Techno Viking. The orange buff is gone, so they're not fighting over anything right now. You could at least put your ward on over there.
Yeah.
I would say.
On the buff itself?
No, just like right in this area, yeah. So you just have vision of it.
Totally.
So yeah, what I'm setting Caleb up, those are all basic items that he's going to buy eventually.
Exactly.
And build into something, so you may as well have them early in lane. So the time, for example, is giving him extra cooldown reduction on his ability, so he's spamming his spells harder. The hunger is giving him a little bit of life drain, so when he uses those abilities, he will be healed in lane. And the power is just a little bit extra power. And those items will eventually build into like a decay, an assimilation is what I like to go to. And into a pain. Those are all legendary tier items, but these are the these are the starting points of each of those items. So technically, like, if you had enough Vim, you could buy one basic item for every slot.
Exactly, and build super wide, get your base stats out.
Exactly, exactly.
And then upgrade from there.
Like, I could tell you the basic items that I always buy on Zaugus start with, like, there's, like, one time in there, one hunger in there, and, like,
four. Oh, I totally whiffed that.
And, like, four powers, pretty much.
Yep.
And then I could build out of that.
Oh, look at that Moya ult.
Nice job. Nice
great,
job.
Great, great.
So, yeah, there's definitely something good about being able to build wide like that, mm-hmm. rather than just being like, oh, you know, I kind of want to save because I've already put so much into this one tree that I don't want to go ahead and I'd rather save for that big item than spread myself too thin with a completely different stat and a completely different item. I think it's totally viable to build wide in Dawngate, pretty much.
1 second. Hit. Ah! You threw me off.
Nice
oh,
job,
I got
nice
it.
Job. You got the reset, too. Yep.
I just need a little bit more damage. I'm just going to hit him with it.
You might as well just throw it out. Yeah. How low did he get? He got super low.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to head back.
Good job.
So what about spells? Let's talk spells.
Yeah, you haven't even level 8, haven't chosen your first spell. No big deal. If you had it staggered there, that would have been another kill. Let's just throw that out there.
Yeah, true facts.
So the spell book is a unique system. You pretty much unlock a spell at levels 1, 10, and 20. This is completely agnostic of, you know, your shaper's abilities. These are spells that any shaper can take.
Mm-hmm.
We have offensive, we have defensive, we have utility-based spells.
You can also respec those spells. Yeah.
You can also respec them for 400 Vim. So, mm-hmm. you know, my favorite example there being if you're playing a hunter that needs help in that early clear, you may take a Vanquish, which deals large amounts of damage to a neutral minion.
Mm-hmm.
But late game, let's say Parasite is down, you don't really need your Vanquish. You know, the jungle ain't no thing. Because you're just clearing it so quickly, you can sell your Vanquish for 400 Vim and pick up a Blitz, pick up a Stasis, pick up a Bastion, pick up a Tailwind, pick up, you know, a Blink, anything else. And you're not stuck with that. You know, one of my, you know, biggest complaints about, you know, League sometimes is like, you take Smite as an early jungler and...
And then it's useless.
And then
right?
in the one of the late game team fight when there's no Bear and a Dragon or anything to take, it's just, it sits there.
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
There's no point to it.
So speaking of which, what should I take, Leah?
Gosh, I don't know right now. You haven't really, like... necessarily needed anything like a stagger right there would have been the kill.
Yeah.
So that's
two times that stagger would have saved
you. I would just take stagger then.
Yeah,
at that
let's
point.
Do it.
You're about to hit level 10, so you're about to even get your second spell.
Exactly.
So that's pretty big too. I would take maybe a stagger, and then as soon as you hit level 10, maybe a blitz. I like blitz a lot just because. Oh,
just does he have his ulti?
He already used it. Maybe a Blitz, because I like Blitz. They don't have a ton of CC, I would say, but the mobility it gives you around
just
team fights.
Just to close in, yeah.
Exactly, just to close. You can use it as a close. You can use it as an escape. You can use it just as, like, sometimes when a big team fight mid-game happens, and I know that I'll be the focus because maybe I'm doing well in lane, I'll just pop the Blitz just so I can kind of just... dash around and
totally.
Just be like, hey, I'm running around casting all these high range. Like right now, a Blitz
would have been look at that. Oh, no.
Great pickup.
Ah, damn.
The Blitz would have been great there. And look, you're only like 20, no, you're like 50, 60, something like that. 60 XP away from having had that Blitz.
Right, exactly.
It would have been dope if you would have turned around, killed a creep wave, and then taken Blitz and then gotten out of there.
Yeah.
That would have been the plays. I would have been super impressed.
Man, they're so low.
That is a Zaugus triple kill right there. I know.
Just like, oh!
If you were just in range, you could just take all of them out.
Exactly. See, what should I pick up here?
At this point, I probably save for Destruction.
Yeah.
Because Destruction, super, super high flat power item with a lot of flat defense penetration. It's the highest flat power item in the game. I think it's like 70 power. Is that what it is?
Let's take a look.
100%. 75 power, yeah. It's a lot of flat power.
Plus DP as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the way our stat system works is it's kind of like, I don't know. I like to think of it as like common sense, right? Because it's like power. You hit things harder. You know?
Yeah.
Haste. You do things faster. It's... Mm-hmm. It's a little bit less specific and I think a little bit more intuitive.
Yeah.
Just around what you want your character to be able to do.
Mm-hmm. I completely agree. It's not like you're scared of building accidentally building AP on a physical carrot.
Exactly.
You know, being like, oh my gosh, like what I am have I completely done? Useless. Hey, yeah. at least if you're Caitlin, like we've been saying, your
Q hits
your
hard.
90 caliber net. Actually, I don't even think your Q scales with AD. with AP. So I think the only thing that hits harder is like your E. I don't even think W scales with AP, but it might. Yeah. I don't know.
Anyway.
But yeah, there it is the barrier of entry in that respect is much lower, you know, because if you want to deal damage, you build power.
Right.
Like that is it. You know, it's not like I want to build damage, but I'm not sure if I'm physical or magical, you know? Just build power and you will deal more damage.
Exactly.
It's as simple as that. With that being said, you know, there's no, like, a lot of people will say, oh, where are the boots? How do I move faster? There are certain items that do give you percent move speed, but there are also just the haste stat. The haste stat will make you move a little bit faster.
Mm-hmm.
Every you know, archetype of shaper has a different coefficient for how that moves, how that haste affects their move speed.
Right, like, does it give you more CDR? Does it give you more...
Exactly.
More attack speed, that kind of stuff, so...
So as a range carry, if you're playing the variant or something, buying that haste will give you more attack speed than CDR because you are all about those physical, you know, ranged right-click attacks.
Mm-hmm.
However, if you're playing Zaugus like Caleb is right now, building that haste will give you way more CDR than attack speed. Oh, God.
Oh, no. Big Friday with the KS.
Killed him before you could get the reset on your ulti.
Yeah. Anyway, but oh, well.
That's okay. At least you're level 11 now. You are balling out of control right now.
Yeah, it's getting pretty good.
3-1-2. How low is that binding? I can't even tell. Oh my god. Big Friday. It just wants
so YOLO.
He great. Wants to have his cake and eat it too.
Yep.
And then eat more cake.
All for the kids. Uh-oh, incoming.
Here goes
Volek. Sorry, Volek.
He's chasing you hard.
Yeah.
Get that E off. Just kite him well. Just kite him well. His ulti is off.
Yeah. Almost Q time. He ran. Simplest.
Well. Oh, well. At least you got away.
Yeah,
you
know? Got away.
Can't be greedy and be like, man, I wanted all those kills.
Yeah.
As long as you got away with your life.
Yeah, where's that Omni kill?
Servers are online? No, they are not, Sylvanas12345. This is purely a developer internal playtest.
Exactly.
This is our dev playtest. We stream it. We do it every day, but we stream it once a week on Tuesdays.
Mm-hmm.
So welcome. Welcome to the dev playtest here.
Any questions in the chat?
I'm looking... You guys are making a great game. I know it's not a question, but at least just wanted to let you know. Thank you, RFalk28. We appreciate that. Thank you for your kind words. Yeah, any other questions you guys might have, throw a Q with a colon and then ask your question after that. And if we notice it in chat, which we should, there's not a lot of questions flying in right now, we will do our best to answer that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man, that Volek again.
Here again? Jeez. He wants it.
No, he doesn't. Oh, what? Big Friday does.
Big Friday.
Oh no!
Just barely sidestepped it.
I'm gonna blitz here to disengage off of
that's
this.
That's fine. That's a worthy use of blitz.
Oh, what? Get
just,
back!
Just
here.
Auto attack him. There you go. Okay, now you're dead.
Nah. Oh, all the ults.
That was two
just eating ults for breakfast. Mm-hmm. And
any news in the dynamic music system stuff?
Sure, yeah. That is coming along. We have it scheduled. It will be coming in within the next matter of like a large-ish number of weeks.
What you're saying is soon, TM.
Yeah, I am saying soon, TM, but it's close. We're saying within about a month. But it's tied to some other things, and we'll see.
So, you know, for people that, like, Mighty Morat obviously kind of knows what we're talking about here, but
right. What
is the dynamic music system?
So it's...
Theoretically.
It's a large expansion of the music for our game. And this is for, like, in-game in the client where we are right now.
Mm-hmm.
We're expanding the total amount of music in the game by about... I mean, if you count it sort of in terms of basic audio assets, we're talking about 10 times the amount of music.
Jeez.
So it's a big expansion.
That's no small feat.
No, it's a lot of new music.
Get that ulti.
Oh, come on.
No one wants you to deal the killing blow with your ulti. They just really...
No, they just want... They want the kills for themselves.
So
I don't blame them.
So, theoretically, 10 times the amount of music.
Yeah, and so basically what we're going to be doing is sort of moving to a system where the game will... The music will react to what's going on in the match.
It'll recognize the current state your team is in,
and the current state that you as an individual are in, and react to that.
So theoretically, if I am destroying people as Zalgus, if I am this 5-2 epic awesome Zalgus,
yeah,
and we are winning as a team, mm-hmm. and my teammate is 0-7 feeder, could we be hearing two completely different pieces of music?
I didn't really want to do it on the basis of like individual performance per okay. se. It's more about, oh dear.
Your blitz is almost done, by the way.
Okay, I... Yeah, I'll be fine. We'll kite this off. Yeah, it's more about team performance, so it's not really about, like, oh, I'm feeding, I'm having a sad time, because you don't want...
Sad music, sad right. violin.
That's not the feeling that you want to impart upon people. Mm-hmm. You... Yakety Sax plays when you're going on a blitz rampage as Cerulean only. That's true, that would be funny. But yeah, no, it's really about team feeling, and it's really about trying to get people to feel empowered when they're winning, and to feel encouraged when they're losing.
So it's less about winning music and losing music, and more about winning music and about to make the comeback music.
Yeah, I mean,
to build your, be like, yeah, we're getting into this. You know, we've gotten that spirit well. We've taken the parasite. We've gotten right. the pick. Like, getting back into this.
We can actually do this.
A swelling, more of a swelling.
What are these guys doing?
Oh my gosh! Whoops. Just, you guess you got to go help them now because your team is
duo. Oh, this is gonna go so badly. We just gotta give the parasite up.
Oh my god! Is your team like Vulcan throw bargains? Is that what's happening right now? Looks like it. Oh jeez. Oh jeez.
Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh, we got
that. Did they just try to duo parasite?
Yeah, they did.
I feel like that was ill-fated.
Oh. The parasite is not something to be taken lightly.
No, it's stage 3 right now too.
Right.
Which is. Not it's strong.
Tough sauce. Strong to quite strong.
Yeah.
So decay, you think?
Let's see. You have the destruction. I would go, yeah, why not? Let's pull the decay.
Could I pull a pin? I could go for hostility.
I would do the decay.
Okay. Decay is fun.
And then you could probably build a force after that. Yeah, build a force. So yeah, what I like about decay is that the kind of the burn damage of, I think it's, what's it called? Giant Slayer? Whatever the passive of Decay is, what is it?
It's a Spirit Burn.
Spirit Burn. It, what I like to call, rattles the chains, you know? Because, mm-hmm. like, when you cue a bunch of people, they get chained together, and each tick of the Spirit Burn rattles every right. member of the chain.
Looks like they're having trouble with Parasite, too.
Oh, God. And this
we
is
should
the
be able to pick this up. The Parathrows.
Oh, God. Oh, that was so sad. Did you see the Zeri block? For the variant, yeah, and die. The most noblest of sacrifices, and you guys get peril. Wow,
nice, nicely done, team.
Well, this is not good.
Yeah,
for them. One throw begets another.
Exactly,
is what's happening right now.
Yeah, but all in our favor. I love it. So yeah, the parasite evolves over time, over the course of the match, gives different buffs, different rewards, and is more powerful, gains more abilities, etc., mm-hmm. etc. So good times. For this team going. Good job, matchmaker. Thanks, Ryan Seif and Gasty.
For doing this. What beasts.
Yep.
Let's see. Were there any special music for an Omni kill, perhaps?
So we're looking. So we currently have special VO for all the different tiers of multi kills. It won't be in V1 of the music. Where did that Zeri go? Oh, she just got blown apart.
Yeah.
But I'll be looking to make additions to the music system over time.
Uh-huh.
I have a few ideas as to what I think could be interesting to add to the sort of core base of following your play and your team's play. One thing I wanted to say about sort of trying to... What we were talking about, like, the tone of the music...
Mm-hmm.
This is something that's sort of something that I picked up from working on music games and, you know, making the player feel stagger. So much swagger, die! Oh,
you should have blitzed that King ulti. Yeah.
Is you never really want to make a player feel actually bad mm-hmm. through music, because you want to sort of create a safe social space for experimentation, for making new friends, having fun. And if you're, you know, we all know that MOBAs are tough games, and they can have You know, they're the kind of game that they're competitive.
You know, they can bring out the best and worst in people.
Yeah. Exactly.
So you don't want to, I'm sure, like...
Oh, that just brought out the best in me. What?
So I'm sure you don't want to make it so that the music is making anyone sad or depressed.
Exactly.
Not having a good time.
Right.
You know?
Precisely. Triple kill.
Wow, what a beast. Is that the Necobus? What a baller. But yeah, I completely understand that sentiment. And, you know.
Yeah, and so, you know, when I would do crowd sounds for Dance Central, for example, one of the games I worked on, would bring everybody, a bunch of members of the team at Harmonix, out into a courtyard and be like, okay, put mics out and be like, okay, be really psyched. And then I was like, okay, your best friend just was dancing and wasn't that good, but you want to make sure that they feel encouraged
yeah.
and don't feel too sad. And so, like, that's literally the direction that
I wonder what part of the game that's going in.
Yeah, exactly. So that's
very
sort of the...
Very specific sounds.
Yeah, exactly. That's sort of the vibe that we try to create. Mm-hmm. With the
supportive.
Music. Yeah, supportive.
Rather than, like,
as in
Price
like,
is Right, fail noise.
Things are hard, but we can do it, you know? We can all rally together. It's like Helm's Deep, you know?
Yeah.
Like, that's the kind of feel.
We're vastly outnumbered and undermanned, but we can do it, you know? You gotta have faith. Have a little faith. Have the hope, you know?
Yeah.
There has to be that... Yeah, I think hope is a good word for it. You know, you gotta have that hope. It's
right.
not just... utter defeat music.
So wait, that's like when you use an ability,
you get a 20% CDR, or 20% damage reduction. Like
yeah, 20% sadness reduction.
Hashtag sparkly hype. But yeah, that
4-0-10, big assist.
I completely agree. Yeah, 4-0-10, Andrea, yeah. Caleb, we're rocking 10-3.
Yeah.
Dumathuin, 4-0. God, your team is good. Your team played pretty beastly.
Yeah, we steamrolled pretty well.
So yeah, we do have a few more minutes. So if you guys do want to throw any questions to us in chat, like I said, throw a Q with a colon and ask the question, and we will answer it.
I feel like I've told four half stories over the course of this,
but
and then gotten distracted. One? Yeah, I realize I never finished the whole like Nisa Auto Tech story, but. Yeah, I tell long-winded stories.
That's okay. You know, it's sometimes really hard to do. Like, some people don't realize, like, if you're, like, streaming and playing the game and trying to talk, like,
right.
things will get
things
forgotten.
Things go away.
Things will go unsaid.
Like, yeah, exactly.
It's not easy.
We added frame one auto attack audio to every character so that you get that. It's the auto attack feel is a three-stage thing. And you hear that, as you were talking about in Caitlyn's auto attack in LoL as well. It's like, prepare, shoot, hit. And if you get that, it's that chukka junk.
It's that cadence. Junk, yeah,
that
yeah, yeah.
cadence.
Yeah.
That's what actually. That's like the
it's
secret
rhythmic,
sauce.
You know, it's like
yeah.
da 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 da.
Right. That's the secret sauce to making auto attacking feel good. Especially, I mean, it's especially important on range carry.
Oh yeah, because it's so important.
Exactly.
Because that is, you know, what they do. Their damage is right clicks. You know, like you can make Amaranth Wave and Amaranth Bubble and Amaranth everything sound amazing, but like her auto attacks, you know, like. They're autos, you know?
Speaking
it's not,
of,
like, super important.
Speaking of which, Amaranth Wave is on my list.
Of hardest things to do or easiest? Oh, what
sounds,
just happened?
Sounds to replace. Oh, God, what did I do?
I don't know. Do you hear that? Is that just a me thing?
Everything's okay.
Hold on. We're going to unplug the splitter real quick. Testing.
So that's what all those new shapers are.
See, now your mic isn't working.
Really?
Yeah.
My mic can hear me fine.
That's peculiar.
What did you do? What did you do?
Wait. I think I know. GG.
Oh, GG. Do we need to replace that?
There we go. No,
hello.
It's better.
Amazing. Okay.
It just cut out for a second. It was like, this is weird stuff. Hopefully that wasn't loud for you guys, because it was like, it was super loud in my ears. You couldn't hear any of that?
Yeah. What do you use to make the sound effects things for things like skills? Tell us more of this secret sauce. Okay, let's see.
I like how that was two people, but you read them together and they made perfect sense.
Totally sense. Total perfect sense. So basically when I start designing sounds for a shaper, I start with a set of materials that represent that shaper.
Mm-hmm.
And that is sort of the basis for giving that shaper a unique sound. So you look at, okay, Volok and Freya.
Mm-hmm.
They're both swinging bladed weapons. How do you make those bladed weapons seem different?
Yeah.
Volek is based in, for at least for the metal part of his sort of material set, is based in iron.
Okay.
Freya, steel.
Interesting.
So that actually makes Freya's axes sound a little sharper.
Yeah, I can see that.
And Volek's sword sound
like hefty.
It's like it's dull. Baby, it's like halfway hacking off your leg.
Yeah, he's not particularly like. He's not finally cutting you.
No.
He's just like smashing your leg until it comes off.
And cutting it a little bit.
Yeah, exactly.
And so that's sort of the feel I wanted to get. He's got this massive sword. I want it to feel kind of not terribly sharp, kind of dull.
I can see Freya dual-wielding axes is more like sharp and quick.
Right,
and like precise.
Meat cleavers, sharpened steel, that kind of a feel. So, and then for abilities, it's, you know, it depends. You know, you look at something like Salgas, who I was playing, his Q ability. It's like, okay, he a book appears in front of him. You have to kind of break it down by all the little things that happen. And then, again, try to make the dream version of that. Because, so it's like a book appears in front of him, opens, a spear with chains attached shoots out. And
it's so otherworldly.
Yeah, it's crazy, but I literally break it down to, I almost sort of storyboard it in my head.
A book and sounds like this.
Right, and so it's got like it has all those elements. It's got a little book at the front of it. It's got, and it might not even be stuff that you actually see, but it's trying to like tell that story. Mm-hmm. I'm going to segue this back into the Nissa auto attack.
We're going to do a callback
sound. Call him back. Yeah, so that sound is, a lot of that sound is like the sound of gripping and sort of moving your hands across of a football or like and like a piece, rubbing two pieces of leather together. So I sort of imagine Nissa sort of has like on her belt, her baraga, and it's like a lot of leather and bone. Those are sort of her like
tribal
Yeah, it's a tribal kind of sound. Those are her materials, like leather and bone and fur. And so like she's like pulling it out of its
almost like sheath.
Of its boomerang hilt.
Yeah.
And you want just that, and like gripping it in her hand and sort of twisting it just before she's about to release it. And like, that's all like a tiny little story told in a microsecond.
But it's there in your head.
It's like there in my head, and I try to like pour that into the sounds as much as possible.
Macro level, chick throwing boomerang. Micro level, she's unsheathing it.
Yeah, exactly.
She's gripping it. She's tossing it. It's flying through the air. It's hitting the target. That is the micro kind of breakdown.
And when you're making audio for games, you have to build every single part of that.
Yeah, it's building blocks. Legos.
Yeah.
Audio Legos. until someone comes in and knocks down your Legos. Or you step on one of your audio Legos, and then you have to go to the ER.
Yeah,
stepping on Legos is the worst thing in the world.
I am starting to learn that. My son just graduated to little Legos.
No.
And I'm stepping on them, and it hurts. Let's see.
It is the worst. Servers are offline. Yes, servers are offline right now. This was a completely internal developer playtest.
Yeah.
Servers will be back online probably Thursday through Sunday.
Dongate hoodie? Question? Question Dongate hoodie?
I want a Dongate
hoodie. I want a Dongate really hoodie.
Bad. You know, I get jelly whenever, because like Andy came from Paragon. He was on like City of Heroes for a while. He has a sweet Paragon hoodie.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, I want a Waystone hoodie. Like, I want like a Dongate hoodie. That'd be so cool.
It would be super cool.
We do have the sweet Dongate shirts, though.
They are very sweet.
Those are super dope.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to wear that soon.
Chad, so Champion fun. Buffs nerfs, and are you going to nerf Kindra's totally broken kit, and are you going to make some more lore for each shaper? I'll answer the last question first about lore. Yes. Are we going to nerf Kindra's totally broken kit? I think it's vaguely arguable that she's broken. I think she's very good in, she's a very strong like solo queue for skilled players.
Yeah,
she's a real pub stomper. And what was the first one?
But honestly, I feel like you don't,
buffs nerfs.
If I recall correctly, I was watching Sheeb's team play against Mianhe's team in like the 5v5 kind of tournament. I don't think either team had a Kindra. You know, like I feel like with really, really coordinated team play that you can, there are better comps out there.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. There absolutely are.
So unless I'm mistaken, someone can probably correct me. I bet Mianhe or Sheebs or someone in here is to correct me. But I don't think I saw a Kindra there. But as far as balance and nerfing questions are concerned, you know, neither of us are pretty much the authority on that. Gasty will come over with his spreadsheet and his calculator one time and be like, yes, we are nerfing Kindra.
Right. So to talk about, I mean, I can talk a little bit about buffs and nerfs. I think and this is me speaking for the designers, mm-hmm. so take it. But, you know, with the, we're doing a large-scale item rework that's coming in pretty soon, as well as changes to the map that are coming in pretty soon. Mm-hmm. Those are fundamental changes to how everything works.
Yeah.
So I think we're, you know, probably not going to see a lot of buffing and nerfing until that comes
yeah.
out. And sort of that, do you want to talk about knocking all the Legos off the board?
The map is gonna be interesting.
The map and a whole bunch of items, so
yeah,
that'll be fun.
So you know, as you guys know, as Blue Muzzy specifically will know the most, we had a custom game flow where you could choose the new map or like the beta version of the new map
mm-hmm.
For a long time, and very recently we took that out because the map has had so many iterations done to it that you guys have no idea what is coming out, and
oh,
I'm super excited for it. Scott Moore's back
getting
there.
Hyphy about
Scott
the
Moore's
map.
Back there playing on it right now, the dev play test.
Oh, yeah.
His that new item in the new map that Scott Moore is playing on right off the camera that you can't see. Incredible.
The tease.
We will be out with it, you know. Gast will be on to talk about it as soon as he can. He's mm-hmm. he's chomping at the bit. He really wants to come and let you guys know. Kind of peek behind the curtain.
Yeah,
of
speaking of talking to people about things, do you know who's on the community catch up tomorrow?
Tomorrow should be believe it's Gasty.
Gasty?
It's Gasty. Yeah, definitely community catch up tomorrow at 11 a.m. PST. Mm-hmm. You should not miss it.
Yes, Secret Tony is still two lanes. Still two lanes.
It's still two lanes, yeah. It fundamentally, this map is still two lanes. It still has a centrally located monster. It still has the spirit wells.
Yeah.
Just some paths have been changed. Some slight mechanics have been changed. Again, mm-hmm. Gasty will come on eventually whenever he's able to talk about it and give you the full rundown of everything we've done to the map, and it'll be fantastic. But as far as tomorrow is concerned, Gastatron, the man himself, the man, the myth, legend, will be on the community catch-up tomorrow at 11 a.m. PST. It's definitely one that you're going to want to be here for. He has some really awesome things to talk to you about. So
exciting.
You know,
I'm excited.
I, you know, that's as much teasing as I'm going to do. It's going to be fun. Be there. Again, 11 a.m. PST. He'll be sitting mm-hmm. down with Andy and talking about some cool things coming to the Dawn Gate in the near future. Because, you know, 2014's big year.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be awesome. You know, we started closed beta in May of 2013.
It's
and
true.
It's been, you know, almost 8 months, coming up on 8 months now. And 2014 is, you know,
year of the Dawn Gate.
On the up and up. It's the year of the Dawn Gate. We
yeah.
have incredible features, incredible shapers.
So
the
much
map
stuff.
Rework,
yeah.
item palooza. I'm so excited for the next few months of Dawn Gate.
I know, like the patches,
mm-hmm.
they're so big.
Yeah, I know. We appreciate it. We've got all hands on deck right now. You know,
yeah.
everyone got that 2 week break, and now we're back, and people are nose to the grindstone, just putting out content, putting out features, and it's absolutely bonkers. And you know, shout out to the team. If you see any developer in game over the beta, give them all of your love. Tell them, you know,
yeah.
that
and then yell at them to get back to work.
Exactly. Be like, why are you playing the game? It's Thursday at 2 p.m.
Right.
But yeah, the team is coming together and it's absolutely fantastic. And we're super excited about all the features that are coming out.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, 2014, year of the Dawn Gate.
Mm-hmm.
This is it. We appreciate everyone that's been in the beta since the first week when we started, like May 24th, I think was the first day of beta.
Wow.
We didn't have matchmaking.
Nope.
You know, it was only custom games. We had 12 shapers,
yep.
you know. Some of the roles were different. You know,
mm-hmm.
Predator was only kills and assists. There was no spirit well thing.
Right.
Spirit wells were different. Like, so much has changed, and we appreciate everyone that's been there with us to give us the feedback in 2013. To
and
say,
so much more will change. It's
and I know.
So
I know.
Exciting, yeah.
A lot of people come in and
tease.
Well, some people come in and they have this notion that, like, it's in beta, but it's done. It's like, no, it's in beta because it's in beta.
Right.
Anything is subject to change.
Yeah, I mean, the idea of beta is
a testing phase, you know?
Well, that's what it's supposed to be, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think a lot of people really think, I could arguably said it started with Gmail, right? Of like beta being.
We're in beta.
Right, yeah.
We are in no air quotes beta.
Right.
It is
exactly.
literal beta.
Yeah.
So again, thank you guys all for sticking with us.
Mm-hmm.
Zambot just posted a link to a Logitech promotion we have going on right now.
Yeah.
If you don't have a key, you can click that link, follow some steps on Facebook,
mm-hmm.
and boom, you get it.
Right.
You know, that's it.
Plus, you'll get a sweet
Logitech G
sweet
player icon.
Yeah,
yeah.
Which is awesome.
Which and then also for all the people that have been in the game since before December 31st, 2013, you get a year zero player icon. So
mm-hmm.
super exclusive. The Logitech icon will more than likely be available at some point in the future for all existing accounts.
Right.
But that year zero, there's a hard cutoff in 2013.
It's gone.
That's it. It's gone. Yeah. So thank you to all of the beta participants. It is, you know, one of many. Thank you.
Do I get one?
I don't know. Yes, you should get one.
Okay.
I wonder if there will be special, you know, developer icons and stuff like that. We already have the orange names. So. Do we want more stuff? I really do. It's unobtainium. Yes.
We're yeah. How does Dawn Gate toxicity compare to Strife's no toxic gameplay?
That's 50 Shades of Alpha. Is it? He likes to just say.
God damn it, 50. I love you.
You know, there are measures that Strife is taking towards having a non-toxic community with the, you know, eliminating
character-specific queuing.
Eliminating all chat. You know, it's interesting measures. You know, we have the reporting system in game now. We have the block feature. We have some good preventative measures. It's definitely not the end. Like, we definitely have more stuff to come.
A lot more to come.
You know, we as developers are doing our best to lead by example. You know, which isn't a it's not foolproof. It doesn't mean it'll work. You know, stuff like that. But
right. And shout out to that guy in the chat, Blue Muzzy, for also being a
beast.
Well, just a great example of like
quality,
a pillar of the community, yeah. Right? Of like just being. Being great about helping people.
Anytime I hit
being
that broadcast
super nice.
Button on the stream, Blue Muzzy's like already in chat. He's like, "I've been here for hours. Where have you been, Pluto?" I'm sorry, Blue Muzzy. So yeah, thanks. Thank you so much, Muzzy. We have those people all over. All over the community. Muzzy, Sheebs is great.
Yep.
Mianhe, all those high and mar guys. Just, you know, we encourage you to. Sheebs made a post actually on Reddit the other day that was pretty much less. He said, "Let's." Lessen the amount of shit talking, you know, to put it bluntly. And, you know, he is doing everything he can to lead by example himself. And
exactly.
We need those members of the community to rise up and be like, you know, we are influential and we are trying to make a positive impact in the community. So we appreciate that.
Absolutely.
And you guys like Chaotis, I see him in chat making a sweet montage that Scott Moore was watching just before we started the stream. Really nice montage. I got to say that Kindra play Under the Binding where you got down to 30 health was absolutely dirty.
It was beastly. And,
Yeah, it was incredible. You did say that it was a weekly thing, so I hope to see another one next week. I hope to see a montage every week, Chaotice, so don't disappoint me. You don't want to disappoint a ginger on your hands. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Thanks for sticking with us. We appreciate it very much. That pretty much is going to wrap up the stream for the day. Again, like I said, 11 a.m. PST tomorrow morning. We'll be a community catch-up with the one, the only Gastatron.
True.
You don't want to miss it. If you enjoy the Dawn Gate, there's going to be some cool things said there. So definitely tune in. Nice. If you want to get notified when it goes live, hit that follow button down below on the stream. You'll get an email notification every time we go live, which is pretty much 6 days out of the week. Mm-hmm. But tomorrow is, of course, a specially important day.
Exactly.
And follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/DawnGate, facebook.com/TheDawnGate.
Yeah.
And if you want to register for the beta right now, you can, www.dawngate.com. But you may also visit the Logitech link that Zanbot posts periodically. Let me see. I'm gonna force him to post it.
No.
Zanbot, do my bidding.
Slave.
Visit that link right there. You can get yourself a beta key right now by following a few steps to the Logitech G. Great guys over there.
Yep.
Facebook page. And get yourself a key. And we'll see you in the beta this weekend.
Hopefully. Yeah. Thanks
but
for watching, everybody.
From us here at Waystone Games, that is the end of the show. Caleb and I are going to go back and do some work. You got some audio things to do, I'm sure.
I've got a lot of audio things to do.
I've got those community things to do. Mm-hmm. So thanks for watching again. I am Brad Pluto Raymond, the Assistant Community Manager, joined by Caleb Necobus Epps, our audio director. And we are signing off here on Space Station Zero, a.k.a. Waystone Games. Peace.